Right then, so now we're on to Psycho Killer. So what I'm going to do for you now, I'm going to play the Counting Crows riff and then go into Psycho Killer so you can see how we change from the last chord from Mr. Jones, which is the G, and progress to the A minor, which, although that is the first chord of the Counting Crows song as well, is a slight emphasis and different change of rhythm. So if you watch what I do, you can see how one flows into the other. That. Okay, now David Byrne of Talking Heads plays this. I've heard him play this rhythm on the album 77, which is when they first recorded it. They've got a live album where he plays the rhythm differently, and then he's got Stop Making Sense, which is the full-length video of them in a concert playing that differently as well. So this is the more true to the original studio version. Now, what we're doing here is mainly using upstrokes when we're playing the A minor chord. So there's two chords here, A minor. Again, have a look at the chord diagram. We're playing this on the fifth fret, barred, the A minor, and we're playing a barred G chord as well. Now the reason we're playing bar chords here is because there's a lot of dampening of the strings and relieving the pressure of the strings. Like that. And if you do it on an open chord, more difficult to do. You can play, obviously, the A minor in the open position, but I'm going to show it to you on the barred position on the fifth fret. So it's like this. So we start off in the A minor. So as you can see, I'm mainly using upstrokes. So the riff I'm going to play through a few times for you. Ignore what I'm doing on the G for the moment, but on the A minor, I'm going to gradually slow it down so you can see what I'm doing, okay? So we're going to hit the downstroke to start off with, and then immediately an upstroke. And again. Now, each time I hit an upstroke, I'm relieving the pressure with my left hand, so it doesn't ring out. And then we're going to keep the pressure on and let the actual chord ring out. So you've got three upstrokes that I use to dampen it, and on the fourth, we're going to keep the pressure on the fretboard so that the actual note and the chord rings out, like this. Like that. And then we're going to play, still on the A minor, a little bit of a riff that finishes off the pattern. Like that. It's down, up, down. That's the way I played. Like that. Now you can vary this, and if you want to, you can actually relieve the pressure on your left hand a little bit if you don't want it to ring out. Because I tend to vary it all the time. I play it different, you know, when I'm playing, especially when I'm playing it live. Like that. Okay? So we're just going to play the A minor a few times, and I'll slow it all down for you so you can see exactly what I'm doing. So what I've started doing then is when I'm on the last three, before we get down to the G on the A minor, I'm actually relieving the pressure on the A minor chord. So when I'm playing the downstroke, instead of going, I'm actually going, relieving the pressure so it doesn't ring out. That was totally an natural reaction to do that. It was just the way I was playing on that particular instance. So just relieve the pressure. Doesn't matter what you do, because it's up to you what you do, but that's just sort of my interpretation of it. Okay, so when we've played the A minor, We're then going to go down to really emphasize the G chord. And what we're going to do is this. Like that. Now you don't have to play all those because it's like that to go back up because it's quite quick, so you can shorten it, but I'm just going to show you what I did. So practice doing that. Like that. Quite difficult to get, but once you've mastered it, it's a really satisfying experience. And we're really going to hammer down, up, down, up, down, up, nice and hard on that G, because that's where the real emphasis comes in. The A minor is a nice bit more subtle, but the G is where the power comes in. Okay, just keep playing that over and over again. It's a great riff. Absolutely adore that song. One of my all-time favourites, as it happens. Right, so we've ended on the G there. And if you go forward to the next video, I'll show you More Than the Feeling, which starts on the G chord.